Hi guys, Sean again. I'm going to do a little demonstration. This is a kind of experimental scroll work idea, and someone mentioned to me about shading. He was having problems shading scroll work on a tattoo machine. Engraved. Incidentally, he was using the $65 hand engraving machine, exactly how I use it. Although I'm not using it now, I'm using the POS graver. Anyway, so I always I have a hard job trying to do large scrolls. Always go smaller than I probably should sometimes. But so I kind of just drew up some lines there. To form some leaves, and it will give me something to demonstrate shading. I think I've got the hang of the technique of shading, which will produce a nice result, and if you follow it, you'll have nice consistent looking leaves. The graver I'm using now is a Steve Lindsay 123 degree, and you can see it's nice. I'll demonstrate this bit here. You can see there's nice thin and thick lines, which is the what hand engraving is all about. See that one come out nice, see how thin it is. Nice and thin, just like if it was an ink pen. And also I'm leaning the graver according to the shape of the leaf. Gives it a slight dimension as well, which adds to the effect. Yeah, I drew lines out there, I almost totally ignored them, but it's yeah, not too bad anyway. Right, so I think I'll change. Right, I'm gonna change. I could do shade with the 123 degree graver, but I'm gonna change to the Steve Lindsay 96 degree, because you can get a much finer line. Now, the technique. Oh, it looks quite well doing it big. Right, the technique I kind of aim for. Now, this is two sides to the leaf. Most of my scrolls have this, and I mentioned before, so we're going to come from a center, and this is the right where the split is. We're going to leave a white line, so the first line I'm going to engrave is either side, or I'm going to engrave is either side of this leaf split, and I'm not sure if I should or not, but I'm going to do a do one of them things to create a pipe. Yeah, I think that would look quite nice. Right, so I'm just going to go ahead and try hopefully you'll, so as fine as I can get it, and let the graver dive in naturally and wind in out. So right, I've established that first line. Yeah, you can see it there. Now all lines will go parallel to that, and we'll see how it this is the point. I can't remember his name, but someone from Instagram said he was having trouble getting his lines really fine, and to get these really thin lines, it's just a matter of, there's no trick to it, you just got to practice and practice and practice, because when you get that, like that what I'm doing now, it's touch and go of your slipping, so it's just something you have to practice. When you do it, you probably will either go too deep or you will slip, and you know, if you don't, I mean these are tiny little bit off because I'm trying to talk and engrave at the same time. Right, you see what I did there? So I kind of start, like I said, I started off with this one, which was creating this white band in between our pipe, and then each one is kind of parallel, following the shape, and it runs off the edge. But imagine, so if that arc continued, it all head for this point. So there's like a guide, you know. So rather than guessing, or I don't know how you would decide how to shade, but I've kind of come up with that formula, and it seems to work. Can you finish this, and then have a look and see if it creates the illusion that this leaf has got some dimension. Thank you. So there's another little split in this leaf, so you can do the same idea, leave a little white. I could actually change direction. So I'll do a curve. So I'm going back parallel with the previous line. And letting it run off the edge. Maybe that was a little bit of an experiment, but maybe that worked. Oh yeah, and that's what I was, let me zoom out. To help you with getting this fine shading, so let's zoom right out, I'll show you what my... This is quite a long graver, but what you do is, I describe it as choke the point right up. So there's my thumb. On my right hand, the graver hand, and my index finger. So you go get your fingers right round. Right, you get your fingers right round the front of the graver, and kind of choke it right up. And you also, this is. Let me show you here. I don't like engraving on this. I will do anyway. This is anodized and it seems a bit tough. So look, so these are kind of like a tripod, that's how I described it. So this, my thumb and my index finger are two legs on the tripod, and the graver is the third leg. So what it does, if you're going to slip, you've got a lot of, if you was kind of suspended that graver up without anything, there's nothing to stop you. But with your two fingers there, your thumb and your index finger there, you're less likely to slip. You're kind of creating a handbrake. And if you're using a homemade hand engraving machine, I'd recommend making a foot pedal. It's quite simple to make a foot pedal, because that simple one I made with finger control. I'm sure if you practiced anything, you would get good at it. But the one that I made had the foot pedal. I could do almost anything with it. It's just slightly more awkward to hold, so I tend not to use it. Right, so I'll go back in again. I'll repeat what I'm doing, so it reinforces. Let's go right, we'll zoom right in, maybe that'll help. All right, that shows, yeah, showing up nicely, these big leaves. Right, so there's our pipe. I started off there to make a little white space here, so that established the first line, and I went to the other side of the pipe and then followed that curve, kind of like a followed that curve and then continue on. And it's up to you how close, the closer you add these, the finer your shading. But it's a lot more work, so I think now I'm doing that. There they are now, I think they're adequate. Yeah, doing it like this, yeah, I mentioned before that I tend to overshade. This, using this technique, it prevents you from overshading, because you shade enough and then when you run out of room you stop. So if there's no room to get a line next to the previous line, then you've done enough shading. And I've got another one there. That's tricky. I think I'll go with this one. There's kind of another split, but I'll go with this one. See what happens. I mean, what I did here, these leaves, it's not something I would normally do. It was just, I wanted to do something large. I would have these leaves inside some scrolls, so it would be a bit more logical. But yeah, I don't think this will, this one doesn't really work, I'm not sure. Hopefully you might be able to get a sense, you can kind of hear the graver. Makes a slightly different noise as it goes deeper, so then that translates to a darker line, from a hairline to a darker line. Yeah, I missed that. Like, I kind of jumped on the edge, started off too deep there. But if you get 90% of your shading right, you slight mistake, it won't. It's hidden. But if you're interested in scroll work, you'll scour the internet for different scroll work to study, and so you see some scroll work, there's not one single mistake wrong with it, which is unbelievable, because like I said, I never not slip when I'm doing something, so you just slip less and less. Oh, I missed one. Right. Probably, so this is one technique of shading. I'm sure there is another one, I may come up with it. It's just, this creates one effect. And also, if you really get into shading, then if there was light shining on the plant, one side would be darker than the other, you know. Not so much engraving, but I've seen that in old illustrations. And you've got to understand what you're doing. Oh, it shows up quite, so they're not even, because I'm using a carbide, so yeah, it creates a nice black line. But I will put, I'm going to put some Rust-Oleum matte black on the paint, on the, in the lines, just so it shows up better on the camera. Oh yeah, that bottom one I think worked really well. It's exactly what so this looks, this part looks raised and this looks lower, so it looks like a nice dimension scroll. Not, oh, I could have put some more, could put just a few more lines in this one, that would look better. Don't look too bad. Yeah, for a quick demonstration, I'll give you the idea, but this one looks, this one worked well. So I'm still experimenting, still learning. You never stop learning. I don't think you ever know how to engrave. You discover all the time, so it's a kind of, it's frustrating that you never know it all, but then it's good that you never stop learning. Thanks everybody, hope that helps. Cheers, bye.